Well, when it gets cold and wet, people like to get away. They're anxious to head down to Cuba, Dominican, Florida. And with our direct flights from Ottawa, it's very popular.
Tonight.
Planning for Snow Spree right now as well, which is our winter carnival. And typically, winter carnivals are obviously run outdoors, so it throws a monkey wrench into things, definitely.
Tonight.
It's a really good chance to see how everybody else plays from, like, the States and from here.
Live from the new RO, this is Ottawa's News.
Good evening. The big story in Ottawa tonight is the slushy, icy mess we woke up to today. And there's more on the way. But as nasty as the weather is, it's not dampening the spirits of those in the travel business. Many capital residents are setting their sights on the sunny south. And the new RO's Tricia Owens has our story tonight. Tricia?
Tony, this is definitely the time of year when many Ottawa residents decide to take a little break from the Canadian winter weather. So tonight we find out where they're heading and how travel agencies are coping with the New Year rush. What are your thoughts on this slushy, slippery weather?
Well, I thought it was great for Christmas because it was white, but then all the rain came and made everything slushy and slippery. So, yeah, breaking your head is really easy.
So it's not an enjoyable time for you to be outdoors?
Definitely not, especially having to shovel it all away.
This kind of weather, does it make you want to get away someplace tropical, warm?
If I could afford it, that's where I'd be, yes.
How about you? Would you like to go someplace warm, or do you like it cold here?
I don't like it cold.
You don't.
So you would maybe like to go where? Where would be a good spot, you think? Florida or something?
Florida.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. So you're going to work on Mom and see if she'll take you away somewhere?
Yeah.
The freezing rain, slippery roads, and the call for more snow over the next few days has many Ottawa residents thinking about heading someplace warm and tropical, and that means big bucks for those in the travel business.
Well, this cold weather coming, the slush and the snow, we've had our busiest week yet. And the phones are ringing off the hook and people are really anxious to get away.
So this is a good time to be in the travel business then. You like it when it gets kind of lousy outside.
Well, when it gets cold and wet, people like to get away. They're anxious to head down to Cuba, Dominican, Florida. And with our direct flights from Ottawa, it's very popular.
We're going to Santa Lucia in Cuba this year.
Have you been there before?
Not Santa Lucia, no. We always try and go away when it's cold up here, so get some heat somewhere down south.
So you're kind of sick and tired of the weather. You need a little break?
Absolutely.
And as a matter of fact, the month of January is the most popular time for travel, and many agencies are busy coordinating last-minute package deals.
I've got anything from Mexico to Cuba to the Dominican at as much as 50% off the regular brochure rates, and we're booking these things pretty much daily for people leaving today, tomorrow, next week, 2 weeks from now. Come on down, we'll get you out of here.
Many travel agencies in the city will be offering special packages throughout the month of January, so you definitely have several options if you're looking to escape from the city. Tony.
Good time for it, Tricia. Thank you. Meanwhile, the valley is usually our region's winter playground this time of year, but without the snow and ice, the skates, skis, and snowmobiles are sitting idly by. New RO videographer Doug Hempstead is live in Pembroke to explain. Doug?
Well, Tony, aside from the weather simply disappointing those who like to ski and skate, those who organize or profit from outdoor recreation here in the valley find themselves in a desperate situation.
There's a bunch of cracks, and yesterday a girl sprained her ankle, and it's just really, really bumpy.
If you're one of those people who loves outdoor recreation in the winter, the Ottawa Valley has many things to offer, but it's contingent on two things. Number one, lots of planning. Number two, decent weather. And so far this year, we have not been receiving the latter. On the ground right now, there's little more than an inch of snow. And here's what we were all greeted to earlier this morning. Freezing rain. And temperatures today are supposed to rise to about 5 degrees.
Well, it's a key time for us, that's for sure, recreation-wise, and it throws a monkey wrench into things, definitely. We're planning for Snow Spree right now as well, which is our winter carnival, and typically winter carnivals are obviously run outdoors, so it's going to pose a big challenge to put everything together.
Thank you for calling the Ottawa Ski Club. The snow we received is not sufficient to allow us to open the hill today.
Well, there you get the picture. The Petawawa Ski Club has been in operation for 42 years, and it seems to me I was here last year as well, talking to them about the very same thing. And it's a sign that this weather is starting to affect local business, and that this is a sign of the times.
We still have major expenses, such as paying for our groomers. Our particular case, we have a groomer where we pay $4,000 quarterly, and that totals $16,000 per year. The lack of trail pass money coming in definitely is affecting our progress as far as our financial status.
Snowmobile trail passes, which pay for new groomers and the like, appear to be down by 50% right across the valley. And according to the papers that crossed my desk today, Tony, the earliest we can hope for snow looks like Monday. So cross your fingers.
You certainly will, Doug. Thank you.
Thank you.
The weather's not exactly the best for outdoor fun with the kids, but there is plenty going on indoors to keep the little ones entertained. That takes us to the Museum of Civilization, the site of a magical performance this weekend by Montreal's Carbone 14.
Tall white bird.
Well, the terrific thing was that instead of watching TV for a change, I went out to see this amazing show. The acting was superb, the puppetry, everything. We went to one last year as well. Just fantastic.
We don't usually see this kind of thing, me and my family, so we came here today to just see something special, and it was.
There's another show tomorrow afternoon at 1:30, but if you head over there early, there's an arts and crafts workshop starting at 1. Still around town, the Canadian Currency Museum is keeping the kids busy this weekend as well. That's where a special exhibit is teaching them all about the value of money.
Class school's been out for 2 weeks. It's a good place to come and pick up on a bit of a history lesson. Certainly lots to know here as far as the currency goes. It's the background to the history, but to look at the cultural changes and everything that's occurred over the time and how money played a role in it.
Well, we didn't have much to do, so we decided, hey, come on down to Ottawa, take a look.
Excellent.
And so we're planning to have a good time.
Excellent. What have you discovered here at the Currency Museum today?
About how old some of the money is, what they use for cash, ships that sank with money with them.
For more information on the events at the museum, you can click on to www.currencymuseum.ca. That site again is currencymuseum.ca. And the best part, admission is free.
Finished second by 1 vote.
And although hockey fans and your family likely aren't playing any pond hockey this weekend, there is still a chance to get your sports fix. The Hockey Country Show is in full swing at the Civic Center.
Mike Vernon is our
writer. We thought the show was amazing. We came down here for the Bell Canada Cup for our son, and this was a real addition to the tournament. It was great.
Oh, it's a fantastic show. You know, actually, it's a great opportunity for people to come in here and experience the new wares of hockey, you know, the new ideas in terms of equipment, in terms of, extracurricular activities such as games and those types of things. But it's a good place for organizations to showcase what they have to sell to the kids.
The show is offering the latest in hockey gear, collector's memorabilia, and a chance to meet the Ottawa 67s. But you only have until 9 o'clock tonight to take in all the fun. Well, one Ottawa tradition is packing up for another year, signaling the end of another holiday season.
Today is sort of a day of a little bit of tears and a little bit of smiles. As you can see, it's coming down. We're finished for another year. But we've already started planning for next year, and we're hoping that, maybe bigger and better. We learn things this year that we'll use next year, and hope that all the kids from 8 to 80 want to come back and see us next year.
The magical village in Place d'Orleans has been delighting Ottawa residents since 1998. It is, of course, an important fundraiser as well. It's for both the Gloucester Emergency Food Cupboard and the Gloucester North Lions. Well, it's time to head outside now and take a look at our streets. Looks like it's pretty quiet out there right now. The Ottawa Police Service and the OPP say all roads and highways are clear with no obstructions or collisions to report across town at this hour. Tonight, police are releasing the names of three Ottawa residents who died in that grisly crash yesterday near Montebello, Quebec. 26-year-old Monica Vegue, 29-year-old Manu Vegue, and 27-year-old Angelie Patil were all killed in this head-on crash on Highway 323 yesterday morning. They were heading north in a Honda Accord when the driver lost control, slamming into a southbound minivan. The two other people in the car are still being treated in hospital, while the three people in the van were not seriously hurt. Police believe road conditions may have been to blame, but their investigation is continuing tonight. And tonight, the Gatineau Fire Department is pegging the damage at $120,000 after a stubborn blaze at an apartment building last night. Huh? Fire officials say four of the six apartments in this complex on A2 Street were unoccupied. But tonight, the residents of the other two units, which were heavily damaged, are still not allowed back inside. It's still not clear how the blaze started. It is expected, though, that more information will be released on Monday. Well, coming up next on News 6 Ottawa, another airline tragedy overseas. Experts from the United States and France are trying to find out what went wrong after a charter jet crash in Egypt. World News is up next. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Welcome back. The death toll stands at 148 people tonight after an Egyptian plane crash in the Red Sea. The airliner was heading for Cairo when it disappeared from radar screens minutes after takeoff, killing everyone on board. Most of the travelers were French tourists. According to the Egyptian aviation minister, the cause of the crash was entirely technical and not linked to terrorism. In Iraq, three U.S. soldiers are dead after two separate attacks last night. One soldier died when rebels hit a U.S. base with mortar shells. Officials say six people were held for questioning. Meanwhile, two other soldiers were patrolling south of Baghdad when a homemade bomb exploded. Three others were injured in the blast. Some call it a miracle. 8 days after that massive earthquake in Bam, Iran, an elderly woman is pulled alive from the rubble. The woman, believed to be in her 90s, appeared to be in good health when she was found wrapped in a blanket. No other survivors have been found since Thursday when three people were rescued. Experts say it's extremely unlikely to survive without food or water for more than 3 days in such conditions. And for the first time in nearly 5 years, the Indian Prime Minister visits Pakistan to build on peace efforts. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who arrived this morning for a South Asian summit, shook hands with Pakistani counterpart Zarifullah Khan Jamali. Since the last summit in 1999, the two nuclear-armed nations have almost gone to war twice over the Himalayan region of Kashmir. The meeting is seen as a historic opportunity to resolve the long-standing dispute between the two rivals. Well, your weekend weather forecast is coming up next on News 6 Ottawa. It's a slushy and sloppy mess out there today, but get ready. We are in for a real blast of Arctic air by midweek. The details after this short break. Stay with us.
Hi, my name is John. I'm at Jack Purcell Park trying to play some hockey, and you're watching weather in the new RO.
Thanks for that, John. Well, this time last year, we were lacing up our skates for the first day of fun on the world's longest skating rink. But tonight, the Rideau Canal isn't anywhere near ready, and the NCC wants to remind you to stay off the ice. It's going to take at least another solid week and a half of cold sub-zero nights in order for the canal to be ready. Right now, the ice is about 2 inches thick, but 10 to 12 inches of ice is needed before it's safe for skaters. That brings us to a look at the weather forecast. Let's start off right now with your current conditions. Right now in the capital, we are sitting at 2 degrees under foggy conditions and overcast skies. The wind is coming from the south at 9 kilometers per hour, and no wind chill to speak of right now. Looking at our overnight conditions across the region, clouds right into the upper valley, -8, Pembroke, Renfrew, down through to Arnprior as well. A little milder here in the capital region, lows of -4 as we head into the eastern part of the viewing region, -2 in Alexandria and Cornwall, and remaining at about that down the 401 corridor as well through the Seaway Valley, -2 to -1 through Brockville, Gananoque, and Kingston. Tomorrow's looking like this. Chance of some flurries in the upper valley. A few sunny breaks as well. -8 from Deep River right down through Renfrew and Pontiac counties into the capital region. Much milder here in Ottawa, -2. Same with Gatineau as well. -1 in Prescott Russell, then -5 for the eastern areas. And heading down the Seaway Valley, highs of between -2 and -1 with, again, a chance of some flurries. And here's a look now at your 5-day forecast for tomorrow. We're going to see cloudy skies, a high of -2. And then for Monday, it's going to be a little bit cooler, high of -5 degrees. Could get some snow on Monday as well, with a chance of flurries. Sunny breaks on Tuesday, then the deep freeze hits, only -10 on Wednesday with a chance of flurries. And then get this, -22 is our expected daytime high on Thursday with a few cloudy periods. Well, enough dreaming now, back to reality. And in the sports world, that's a whole lot of hockey this weekend. Over to Ken Reed to fill us in. Ken?
Hey, Tony. On tap tonight, one more win in Canada will go for gold at the World Juniors. We will do the volleyball thing and the NFL playoffs kick off. And up next is Sens and Caps set to get it on. Sports next.
At the Hockey Country Show, and you're watching sports on the new RO.
Hockey everywhere today. Time for your Saturday sports roundup now. For that, we send things over to Ken Reed. And big news for Team Canada at the World Juniors, Ken.
Yeah, no doubt about it, Tony. A spot in the gold medal game up for grabs for Team Canada at the World Juniors today. All they have to do is take out the Czechs in the semis, and they will be going for gold in Finland on Monday night. Just 1:23 in, split the D. Nigel Dawes, nice stop. Celebrate 1-0 Canada. 10 minutes later, Tim Brent to Dan Paille and celebrate yet again. Open cage. Canada on top by a deuce. To the second period we go. Closer. Canada up 2-1. Jeff Carter on the power play. Big goal. 3-1 Canada after two. Third period. Carter shorthanded. Alone. The patience. So nice. 4-1 Canada. Canucks not quite finished yet. 5-1 Canada. Ryan Getzlaf of the Calgary Hitmen makes it 6-1. The sweet wrist action. Canada dominates the Czechs. A 7-1 final. The Canucks will play for gold on Monday. So now the question is, who will they face? The answer, Team USA. Dan Fritchie, smooth hands in the third. The breakaway, that makes it 2-0 USA. They hang on for a 2-1 win over Finland in today's other semi. Canada and the States face off for gold on Monday. The Ottawa Senators are in a groove. They are undefeated in 8 tonight. The Sens looking to go 9 in a row without a loss when they take on the Washington Capitals at the Correll Center. Marty Havlat will not be in the lineup tonight. He's been suspended for 2 games for a kicking incident against the Islanders on Thursday night. No matter. Good teams, they say, are of the deep depth variety. Someone should step up. Amongst those stepping up lately, the guys on the point, the Ottawa defensive corps, doing their fair share of the offensive thing. Of course, that can only help the cause.
Part of it. I think all the guys on the blue line can get up there and make a difference. I mean, if you can be up there and be part of the attack, it makes it a lot tougher on them to, you know, to just more awareness, I guess. And you're always forcing them, and sooner or later something's going to give.
If you have defensemen that can jump up and join as much as possible, it's definitely an advantage for your offense. I think you know, it's got to do with, you know, the defense trusting that the forward will stay back if they go. And it's very important to create scoring chances that everybody's involved.
NHL this afternoon, Atlanta, Montreal, 3-0 Montreal late in the third. Check out the pass. Joe Juneau, Nicholas Sundstrom, so easy. Montreal all over the Thrashers, 5-1 final. It's another day at the Bell Canada Cup, but more than just games on the go at this tourney. A lot of the young dudes in this tourney have got the right stuff. Today, they're showing it off in the skills competition.
I did the agility, no, the speed race with 5 guys, and I went last, and we came in fourth.
This is our first time here, and it's been pretty amazing to watch all these teams come to one location and play hockey. This is his third year playing, but this is our first time up here, so this is pretty neat.
I'm having a good time because there's lots of people to meet, and there's all kinds of training with pins, and it's a really good chance to see how everybody else plays from, like, the States and from here.
Day 2 of the Quality Hotel Ottawa Volleyball Invitational at Ottawa U. The Lady Gigi's 2-0 heading into today, courtesy wins over Ryerson and McGill. Ottawa taking on Sherbrooke this afternoon. Second match, Ottawa up 1-0. Check out the kill action on Melissa Maddox. The power 10-6 Gigi's, but it is not always about the power. Long rally here. Ottawa wins it with the delicate touch. Ellen Barwise, nicely done. No final in yet. This tournament wraps up tomorrow with the final game at noon. The NFL playoffs are on the go. Two wildcard games on tap today. One of them is already underway. The Tennessee Titans dropping into Baltimore doing the AFC wildcard thing. NFL co-MVP Steve McNair living large in charge for the Titans. McNair's offense grooving early, second and goal. Chris Burns, not a problem. Add the convert, 7-0 Titans. More McNair to the air. It is tipped and picked. Will Demps the hands, picks it up at his own 44. He will not go down, gets the blocks, has the legs, takes it to the land of six. Add that convert, 7-7 your score. Baltimore, they add the field goal late in the first half. 10-7 Ravens right now in the third quarter of play. Your other game, Cowboys and the Panthers tonight at 8. That's it for me, Tony.
Thanks very much, Ken. If you've got a story idea for us, sports or otherwise, here at News 6 Ottawa, we'd love to hear about it. And this is how you can reach us. Just a few minutes left. Time now for a look at your wake-up weather forecast. Tomorrow morning, you can expect some clouds and a temperature of -2. It's not going to change much by afternoon either. Cloudy and -2. Tomorrow morning's winds are expected to make it feel like -7 with the wind chill, and the air quality tomorrow should be good. And just before we go, he is drawing a lot of criticism for this stunt, but crocodile hunter Steve Irwin is defending himself tonight. You may recall Irwin fed a huge crocodile with one hand while holding his infant son in the other.
And watch! Good boy, ball. Run down to the water there.
In front of that crocodile, I was in complete control. Absolute and complete control. That is my profession.
Game on.
The stunt isn't being seen as all fun and games for child support and family groups. They say it bordered on child abuse. Irwin has gotten a visit from police, but they say he didn't break any laws.
I love that dude.
Does it remind you of the criticism that came after a certain other baby dangling incident?
A little bit,
over
but
a balcony?
I'd rather be dangled over a balcony than a crocodile. I wish I could make that much money being that stupid like that Irwin does.
A croc, he calls it, right?
He's an awesome dude, though, so I don't know.
He is.
He could dangle me over a crocodile. I wouldn't mind.
Don't know if we'll see that stunt anytime soon.
Hope not.
That is our time for tonight. Join us again for some more of your best local news, weather and sports, coming up tonight at 11. For now, have a good night.
Crikey!
Watching local news on the new RO's News 6 Ottawa.